Hello, Drie fans. Here's Earl Grey. Today I want to talk about the comic that followed Salammbô in the Lone Sloan series by Philippe Drie. And this book is titled Chaos. This book is the English translation that arrived today at my doorstep. And I want to talk about this one here right now. I have an older French version of the story from the publisher Albin Michel for comparison purposes, especially to see if Titan Books has finally dealt with their coloring problems, with the reproductions. I always have a bit of a problem, sometimes more, sometimes less. And spoilers alert, this time they managed it. This book here is pretty amazing in terms of color reproduction. Another thing that always is of some kind of concern for me is the lettering in these books. And I'm not too fond of this font here that tries to mimic handwriting or hand lettering. But I looked in this older book here from 2000 from Albin Michel, and they used kind of a similar font, still a bit more Art Nouveau, so I think a bit more fitting to the world of Philippe Drie. I don't know why, but I feel this is a bit superior lettering, but yeah, no reason to for big complaints actually. As to the story, this is a very typical Drie story, very wordy, pathos galore, especially in the beginning, very, very high tone, insanely fantastic graphics, obviously, sometimes there are some photos collaged into these pages here, a lot of experimentation going on. But story-wise, you need some pages to get into the brain of Drie to figure out what he is actually wants to feed us here. And the first part of the story could have called the funeral, because Lone Sloan is delivered to this planet ruled by an evil guy called Shan in a golden sarcophag. He seems to be dead, but if you have read Salammbô, the previous volume, you know that this is maybe not true. But nothing more happens, despite the great graphics here. The allegedly dead body of Lone Sloan is put into a train that races through the surface of this planet. And here we have Shan, this guy here. Here we have the aforementioned train with Lone Sloan and the soldiers in it. As usual, you have to turn the book sometimes to get these huge poster-like panels. And at some place you recognize the deeper meaning, if you will, of this comic here, for there's a female character following the whole plot here. So as very often in these Drie comics, if not in every Drie comic, there is this underlying relation to the human condition, to our basic emotions like love and desperation and so on. And here the metaphorically or not so metaphorically message of the comic here is love defeats death. Very literally, if you look at this cosmic blowjob here. And then Lone Sloan pops up back into life. Wham. this is Drie in a nutshell, really. Knowing no borders, no limits, just creating fascinating, out there stuff like nobody else does. And here we have one of these pages where you have to turn the whole book. So this is really fascinating stuff, but just to be clear, what kind of prose you're dealing with here. I want to read this little passage here to you. The female character legend says here, "My father is the master of lucid song. At the end of the third 7-year shamanic cycle, at the heart of the red city whose location no one knows, the city whose walls thrum with forbidden sounds, his thought was unveiled. And then my father sang the lost psalms of ancient earth, those of Alphonsin Dismonuth, serene master of the great ram. Hail, is there such a thing as a dinosaur musician, a lizard with the mind of Kant, a spider that dreams of Mozart, a sapiens who believes himself a butterfly? Life is the world's symphony, and we are all of us its heart and soul. Hail." So this sounds a bit thick when you're reading it the first time, but to be honest with you, I like it each time I read it a bit more. A pleasant surprise for me was the appearance of this character called Wuz. So that there are some connections between the different Druyer verses. And speaking of different universes, comic universes, this will maybe remind you of the DC multiverse and other parts of this comic, for whatever reasons, will remind you of different or other comics like the Silver Surfer Druyer style here, or there's a Texaurus, Texauri thingies here. They have a bit of a Star Wars feel, haven't they? But overall, it's of course 100% true Druyer and highly recommended. I just have a little complaint, and this is because of this bonus section, because it's not a bonus section at all, just a mere reproduction of these covers here from the previous volumes. And hey, they could have done better, at least find any guy who is willing to write some pages of about his love or his special angle about Philippe Druyer or on the works of Philippe Druyer. Last but not least, let's compare the older Albin Michel version here with our new Titan book here, and we see the newer version is, surprise surprise, even a bit superior to the older one. The orange tones and the red tones are a bit brighter, more intense. Some details are more clearer. If you look at the planet above here, this is a bit drowned in dark tones, while it's here clearer. And there's really nothing to complain. It's not so dramatically different that when you have read this in French, you don't need, I guess, to upgrade on the new Titan comic. But it's soothing that we who read the stuff here in English don't get an inferior copy. And sometimes the colors are not as intense or as in the older one, but I think for a good effect, because I really like these this coloring here. It feels a bit more precise, and you can make these kind of observations for almost each page. This is the older one here, and if you look very very close, you can see some blurriness, while the newer one seems pretty crisp. And yeah, you wouldn't be aware of these slight differences if you don't put these books side to side. So overall, I'm very satisfied with the new Titan edition of Chaos from Philippe Druyer. Thanks for listening and watching. Goodbye.